My name is Rachel Di Santo. I'm actually a postdoc, so this is the first year of my first postdoc. So I'm working in David Weinberg Lab, and we work on translation. I'm from a small town in Scotland called Dumbarton. So I kind of went to primary school there and high school there. And then, so my parents, they didn't go to university. They kind of work, my dad works for the Ministry of Defence, a kind of engineer there. And my mum works in the kind of job centre, so she works for the UK government. So they're not scientifically inclined at all. And it was really in high school that I became interested in science. It's one of those things where you take the classes, you don't know what you're going to like. And I really liked biology especially. So I decided I wanted to go to university, and I really liked biology. So I decided to go to the University of Glasgow, which is quite near to my hometown. And I chose as my degree biochemistry because I liked the sort of molecular side of science. And so it really kind of grew from high school.
So how does the research that you're doing here have the potential to affect people's lives?
I guess the reason it's important in a sort of medical sense is that you could describe it in a way as basic science. So I'm currently working on yeast. So budding yeast is a model for how our cells work. So medically, it's not at the stage where we're looking at it in humans. But that kind of science is important because if you understand how things work at a very basic level, you can always apply that upwards. So budding yeast cells are very similar to our cells. The processes that occur in them are very similar to what occur in humans. So anything we learn can be directly applied to medicine and to human cells. So I think that's why it's important, and it's good to do basic research because it's much harder to do what we do in human cells, if that makes sense. It's good to use that model. And I came from a lab who also worked on yeast, and the idea was similar. It's like if you can manipulate and look at how something works in a more basic organism, you can learn a lot that applies all the way up to our cells. It's good to think that every project you take on, you could find out the answer. So if I was able to sort of publish something that other scientists could see and say, this is the answer to this problem, that's kind of how I'd like to contribute. And I guess in general, it seems like science is moving towards being translational, which means that everything you do on a research scale should be important to medicine, and they're sort of moving together a lot more, so people talk to each other a lot more about those kind of things, like how does my research influence medicine. So it would be good if in the future you were able to sort of bridge that gap as well. So you could work in yeast, which is like quite a basic system, but then a doctor will say, oh, that's really interesting that you found that out, that could be like good for us. It's always nice for a scientist to figure out the problem. So that's kind of how I'd like to contribute.